I look better on film. Second drawing wheel.
Ignition itself, and I remember hanging there. It's the first time I ever experienced that thing, things going in slow motion. And I remember the legs going by my head and hanging there. And once again, it's like everything went into slow motion. I just remember this little voice. It was probably my father screaming from the fuel. This little boy said, "Just let go." And I just let go. The horse jumped over me. And I was perfectly fine. So just let go. circle, which comes first? In the order of teaching. Thank you. Leg yield. You can't circle until the horse can leg yield. Leg circle is created by moving the horse out onto the circle, away from your inside leg. That way you get a round circle that will extend. Not bad at all. Now let's stretch all the way down. So if you're not stretching, that's going to move away from your leg. So see how he's lost contact? He's pulled on your right leg. He's lost, totally dropped the contact on your outside leg. Now down the center line, and again, leg yield to the left. Good there. Quiet, slowly, contact both sides. You're only trying to keep the slack out of the ring. There's never any backwards tension. You can give a dead once in a while, but there's never any consistent backwards tension on top of the horse. But the biggest thing is to learn to drive and climb back, which is just the weight of the rein. Not to feel loose in the reins. You can actually feel the mouth of the horse. So this riding is not riding around throwing away the reins, it's riding around on a loose rein. It has nothing to do with what we're doing. We're learning to ride the horse and give back to the weight of the rein. There's only way we can give to the point where nothing is bothering the horse. If you keep backwards tension, you're punishing the horse all the time. So how's the horse going to like what you're doing? Because you're punishing it all the time. Like that, like that, like that. That's why we see so many unhappy dressage horses. Pulling on the rein, you're keeping at the same time. It's just like driving your car. If you're doing that for long, you don't have a car. Same thing with your horses. So it's like you're a little bit more to the outside. There we go. Same thing. You come out there. It's just like that. Now that's really quite nice. Now that time, really relaxed. I've got a little more stretch now that time after that. So you just tend to come out a little bit longer. There you go, like that. Put it on down. Stretch on down. That would have been nicer if you had a little more stretch, but you at least got the position. So you can get right back over here again, we'll tap your inside leg there, we'll start trying to look out. And that's kind of why we need to go do the lunge line work for this horse on the side. So we can stop this idea that you just come out of it while we're doing the steel pump. Change the ring across the diagonal. So first we're going to leg yield, and now we're going to use shoulder ribs. Take the cross diagonal, and then we're going to shoulder in down that side. Always softening in the beginning as you're letting it. If he wants to go down, he doesn't think that's all he wants to. Thank you. circle here around me. Shorten your reins a bit. We're going to try to do some trot work here. Good. Let's stabilize the log. Once again, it kind of pops up. Taking the slack out of those reins. Soften a little bit by just squeezing your reins a little bit. Soften it out. Wherever you feel the most tension. Some people will say, hopefully, soften the inside reins. Depends on where you feel the most tension in the mouth. Of course, this outside where you feel the most tension. And then you take that side. Out of center again, getting back to the stretch again. Yeah, good. Now just start to drop. Don't pull away the waist, slack out of the ring, it's all over the place. Start to drop. I think the ring's a little shorter now, just at the beginning of this. Now you're rising to what we call the outside diagonal.